Hey, what's up? Cutman here. We're going to be remixing Pokken Tournament, and I've been working on this track for a couple days now. And what I like to do when basically arrangement is all done is go through every track and do a final check. So this whole stream is going to be the final check of all 25 audio tracks. Oh, looks like there's 24. See, I'm already making this project better. And the way I keep track of what tracks I worked on is I'm going to give them names. So as you can see, most of them are called audio number. This one just is called hats. Got a hat on right now. And I'm gonna go through with a strict format of how I'm naming tracks to give myself a note of when I have addressed every track in the song and just taken a look at it, basically made sure it's all right. Once I get to the bottom, the track might be done. Woo! Let's get started. This is a remix from Pokken Tournament Magikarp Festival featuring Ralphington. He wrote a bunch of these parts, and you can see we have the audio that Ralph put in. And we're gonna mix it, so let's go. Let's check out this bass track first. In my songs, every track has to have an EQ on it, even if we're not using it. This is FabFilter Pro Q2, and if you could hover your mouse over the waveform, it gives you the results of the waveform over time, which is a nice way to see what the quality of our sound's turning out like. You want to make that pop a little bit more? That's nice. Maybe a little less. I'm not going to cut the low end out of this because it's the bass. I'm going to let this be the deepest instrument. But the other tracks, they're gonna get a cut. Let's check out this drum loop next. Oops. There it is. Ooh, that seems a little sus, actually. I'm not sure what's sus about this, so let's just take a listen. This is just a loop. Oh, the blend mode I notice is at complex, which sometimes gives a little complex. So let's change it to beats and see if that helps. No, it makes it susser. Ooh, wow, this sounds good though. Let's see what the waveform looks like. Because this is a loop, we're kind of limited in the stuff that we can do with it. But some processing never hurt. There's a couple of plugins that I have from Waves that we can use to make drum loops kind of cooler. Some of them are totally stupid, like this one I'm about to try because I bought it and I never use it. It's called TransX. It's a transient shaper, which shapes the little pointy parts of the audio. See these little pointy guys? I'll zoom in on one. Yep, that little guy. This guy right here. That's a transient, the first little spike. And this can shape them in kind of cool ways. It sometimes makes drum loops super dope. Sometimes totally ruins it. Or makes it really not loud, but looking loud. Never, here, I'll just get in there. Try more punch. Kind of makes it sus, bass amp. Oh, that's sweet. What is it doing? It's cool. It's making that bass transient like just whoa. It sounds cool, I like it. Maybe if we can do it with something with the mid-range too. Oh, no, no, no. I'm sorry, that was not a good idea. What about the highs? Oh, this is nice. Turn the sensitivity down so it doesn't hit quite as much. It's clipping on the plugin, but I'm not sure why. The way this thing works is like when you make it big, it just peaks like freaking crazy, but I'm gonna just leave it in for now because it sounds good. Maybe I'll bring this down a little. I mean, it definitely sounds cooler with it, so I'm gonna leave it on. Let's look at the EQ. I think the EQ's probably all right. Wow, we made the bass freaking gigantic. I guess it was huge to begin with. Let's see what a low cut sounds on this guy. Messes stuff up. You can do like here. And what's really gonna make this loop feel like it's part of the song is the reverb. So let's take a look and see if we've set up reverb on this track. Oh my gosh, we haven't. Ableton built-in reverb. Let's hear it. Oh boy. Really sounds like you're in the space. All right, enough of that. We're gonna use my absolute favorite reverb right now. I'm gonna save because sometimes it's not the computer's favorite reverb. This is H Reverb from Waves. And what we're gonna do to really give us the total control over the sound of this thing is put an EQ before it, and then an EQ after it. Do you guys hear that car beep? It beeped like in the same tone of my whamp, so it startled me at first. We're not sussing with this EQ right now. I'm gonna go in here, and we're gonna send this bad boy bass drum, I mean drum loop, into this reverb, and then I'm gonna pick a preset, and then I'm gonna shape it, so let's go. Oh, that's something. Actually, I have this faux Dave's. Dude, his small room is so freaking cool. I kind of like it. Whoa! Holy crap, I like this. All right, so check it out. We're gonna EQ this. See, so we're only sending that top end into the reverb. Let's hear the whole track now, if that reverb sounds totally out of place or not. Oh, I'm gonna name it, because this is what we're doing. We're naming all the tracks. So this is the drum verb. Whoop. Verb, short for reverb, of course. And this is the drum loop 42. This is too cut. Yeah, we need some of that kick, but what we don't need. All right, the reverb's not done, which makes sense. We barely did anything to it. We just picked a preset. Now, my favorite thing about H Reverb is the ability to sculpt the way the reverb is EQ'd. Not the signal after the reverb, but the reverb itself. And we make some nice shaping opportunities. Whoa! I love this thing, man. It's just too cool. And this is a subtle effect. I know that it might be really quiet, and it might be a little bit boring, but it's lit, man. It's lit, fam. See those? No, we don't like those echoes like that. But two tap eighth note sounds nice. Whoa, no. We're just not gonna do that. Oh, but I do like how. I wish it had something not frickin' stupid. Oh, there we go. Sorry, I'm wrong. There we go. These all sound like garbage. Where's that 2-1? There it is. We're not doing that. Those output echoes are nice though. There we go. I had the wrong echo on. See, that sounds awesome. I'm gonna introduce another track to this reverb to test it out to make sure it can handle more than one thing in. We have this other hi-hat track, so let's push that in here. Whoa, we're getting wet sounding. And that's great, because this is a remix of Magikarp. Carp. So it's pretty wet, we're gonna bring it back a little. But I think we have our reverb, at least to start this thing out. The reverb is really important, but it's usually something I don't do until like the last pass of the track. It's where you define kind of the shape, the space you want everything to live in. Some tracks, I do that right away. And then other tracks, I do the arrangement. And because I got all these pieces from Ralph, I kind of just built it up. he sent me like 90 seconds. I turned it into this 3.5 minute tune. That's garbage. It's all garbage over there. And now we're setting up the reverb, and we're gonna send just about every track to it. Once we get that nice quality and we feel like it makes sense, we'll start adding more tracks to it, see if it holds up, and if it does, hooray, hooray. So let's keep it going. I think actually I'm ready to set this reverb into the wild, so I'm unsoloing the tracks. We have mixed our drum loop. Do we need an EQ? Do we need to compress? I don't think so. I think it's all right. It's not all right. It's not all right. I'm sorry. Tony Maserati has these plugins. I just really want to get this. I want to get this loop right because it's the only like big unedited drum loop in the song, and it's basically just for this buildup. And if we can get it sounding dope, then it's not gonna be a problem that it's just an unedited loop. But if it sounds kind of flat and doesn't gel with the rest of the track, then like it's not good enough. So let's get in here. Try this Technomaster preset on the Maserati GRP. See if we can't finish this loop and get on to the next instruments. This is sweet sounding. Let's turn the compression down though. If we really crush it, it sounds cool crushed, man. Yeah, dude. Okay. I'm gonna just save this and just try this program drums. Wow, that ruins it. All right, good. Click back and. I like it. Okay, good. Good. I feel like this is ready to rip. Let's keep going. Drum loop two. Oh, look, the bass. I didn't name it. Bass. And we touched this, right? Yeah, this didn't need anything. We got two tracks down. Let's see if I can pick up the pace. Visiting the hi-hats now. Too much reverb. Oh, look at that little shit down there. Let's clean that up. Here's a cool trick for our hi-hats. Take a flanger. Take the dry wet all the way down. Not all the way down, obviously. That would just sound like nothing, but just way down. I'm at like 12%, 10%. And if you can't see it. Oh, look, my green screen. Sorry. That's the flanger. And like, man, this stuff's covering everything. There's the dry wet. Here, you know what? I'm gonna push the little help on, and then I'm gonna just chill over help, all right? So sorry if I was in the way of anything beforehand. And look, I can even blow up the UI a little bit for you guys. Hopefully this makes it a little bit easier to see on the video, because that would be nice, right? Oh, it's getting claustrophobic. How's that? That looks good, right? You can see it pretty good. We're streaming 1080, so should be all right. And I'll give myself a little marker. That's where my frame. Sorry, I should have done this before the stream, but thanks for bearing with me. So now we got the flanger on the hi-hats, and you can see now the hi-hats are kind of moving. It's not the exact same sound over and over. And we have some mixing issues here. Let's mix these claps real quick, because they're easy. They might already be mixed. Let's move on. These claps are done. Nice, see? What's track four? Oh, there's something on it. Another loop. Man, there's a bunch of loops. Oh yeah, this one. These two are friends. Oh, this is a top loop. Top loop is what I use to describe a loop where all the bass is cut out to add like texture. And this is just, This is drum loop 84, loop 84. I'm gonna change. It looks like the only loops are drums in here because all the melodies, the bass line, all that stuff was written by Ralph. And these are just my DJ loops. Let's revisit this guy. Because he's cool, but he doesn't sound like totally clean. That helped. And I'm gonna make a little plateau here. Pull this guy down. And since these two tracks are kind of made to play with one another, I'm keeping them both soloed, but I'm only working on one right now, this top one. You know, that sounds cool. Why don't we automate that? So there's a couple ways to do it. I'm going to show you this way. You hit the little arrow, you press the configure button, and you say, I want to move Pinky's frequency. And once you've clicked it, Ableton puts it down here. Unclick configure, and move this little guy over here. Show us our top loop track. And now we can select in our automation zone, band free frequency. Yeah, yes. We want it to go from here. Let's zoom in. Let's get some room to work. I want it to go from where it is to stay, little baby. I'll just pick this part randomly and see how that works out. And do like, I think it was around here, but we'll listen. Yeah, I don't want to get too close to that hi-hat. Like that. Uh-huh. Yeah. All right. Do this. Now, check it out. I'll highlight the area, go up to the edit menu. You can see that, right? I totally made sure. We're gonna do copy time. Where is it? It's not there. I guess we're gonna cut time. Nope, it's not what I wanted to do. Oh, automation, that's what I'm thinking. Time is like arrangement. It's similar to Pro Tools shuffle view. It like shuffles everything over and duplicates it. I wanna copy automation. Do I have to right click? Copy envelope. Yes, there we go. And I'm gonna put it here. I'll put it here. I'm gonna get rid of this guy. All right, we'll see how this sounds. Let's listen. I'm gonna make this a little bit more dramatic. And because we're only modifying the frequency, I can change the other parameters. Make it like more of a thing. Oh, you know what I'm noticing? Click on the frequency to see it again. It really needs to linger at this point. This 60 point, it really needs to like actually be there, and it's not getting there with this exactly. So I'm gonna try pulling it down a little lower. Oh, look, this is gonna be nice actually. Down to 50, huh? Ooh, I hope this sounds good. It sounds butts when it hits that. It's too low, because when a snare hits in the loop, it sounds weird at a certain frequency. Let's see if this works. Okay, cool, yay. There was just like a little like squeak kind of sound happening that I just wasn't feeling, and we got it out. Oh, this is interesting now. I feel like we need a little boost up here. Maybe just on the sides? Nope. That's annoying, okay. This is such a nice little combo these guys are playing. All right, let's see. All right, I'm happy with that. That was the top loop. Let's visit the bottom loop, which because this is our, what I call the foundation, it has the kick and the snare in it. We probably don't need to do anything to this loop if we don't have to. So let's see. It's got a nice shape. The kick could be meatier, but maybe the bass will play nicely. Let's hear everything in context. See if we got it. Nah, we can make this loop nicer. That's what it needs, that bump. Uh-huh. Another thing we're gonna do this is throw an exciter on it. That's gonna create more harmonics, they're called, but basically frequency. This is Ozone. I like almost don't want to use Ozone 7. I just don't. This is the new one. It's a little CPU hoggy, but hopefully we can hold up. I'm gonna add some harmonics to the low end. We gotta solo it, really hear it. Yeah, you need it. I'm not sure tryout is the way to go. Tube? It's nice, but not what I want. Actually, tube, maybe turn this way down. Ooh, all right. Ooh, yeah. It's like just a little warm, you know? Ooh, this is cool. Didn't really expect to find that in here. Must be the way that it's playing with the reverb. Oh, it's not going into the reverb. Hmm. There's some nice harmonics in this thing. They're hidden, we didn't even know. Listen to it without. Whoops. With. Without. With. Without. The low end's overblown, isn't it? Ooh, yeah, it is. And let's just for hell of it see what it sounds like on tape. Oh, it sounds like nothing anymore. Okay. This is not it. Let's hear it with the reverb. And if that doesn't make it sound solid, then there's one more idea that I have. Way less than that, yeah. Let's hear it with the tops. Oh, they don't have reverb yet. That sounds cool. I want to warm it up more, and I know how I can do it. I'm going to use Ozone 7's, what the hell is it called? Sorry, it's the vintage compressor or limiter? Dynamic EQ. Actually, screw that vintage stuff. We're doing the dynamic EQ because I love this thing so much. I'm going to do Titan Dynamics, which is a nice preset. Oh! Oh, that freaking kick now is just like... All right. Okay, no, I liked it when it was more slammed. Oh. You're taking a little bit too much out of the meat here. This is unusual, this band 6 all the way down here. Usually it's like way up. There we go. You really hear those cymbals now. Uh-huh, yeah. Let's flip this low end. I like how the low end sounds well. Oh, no. Ooh. 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 It sounds nice in the reverb, too. Is the kick too big? Is it too big? Actually, you know what it is? It's the EQ on the reverb. We can cut a little bit more. I had a feeling I wanted to do this with the last loop and I wasn't sure. Hold up. Okay. I don't need a boost. Rolling off the top. Oh, shoot! You hear that? Just like, stuff got clean all of a sudden. We're just rolling the top end off of the... This is the reverb send. So this is the track we're sending all the other tracks to get reverb on them. When we rolled off the top... Whoo! We had still the top from the original, but then we had this nice, warm, spacious mid-range. The kick still. I know. Getting to the reverb. I'll find it. There it is. That. That's a sound in the reverb, and I just don't want it. I just don't want it anywhere around here. So we're going to pull. I'm going to pull it back. Where is it? That's the gain. Take a little bit more off that low too. So we still have a tiny bit of rumble, but it's not like so aggressive, you know. And I'm going to hard cut the low end. Everything under 100. Just be like, no, just don't go there at all. Ooh! I think I got it. That reverb sounds so nice. You can even take a little off the top, a little more off the top. And I cannot stress this enough. This EQ is before the reverb. The reverb comes after. See the reverb's on the right, EQ's on the left, same down here. And if it was the other way around, listen, it would not have the same effect. Sounds so nice, let's flip it around. The kick's like slappy. The high end is like hissy, but cut off. It's a subtle difference. But it's an important one. Let's clean up these mids a little bit. There it is. All right, let's hear the whole track. We've been working on reverb for a while, but the idea is as we sculpt the reverb by adding more tracks into it, when we get down the list and we've done all the tracks, the reverb should be perfect because as we've added stuff, we've adjusted to compensate, and we're basically building the space that the whole song is gonna live in. Let's hear it. We haven't done this in a while. Hope it sounds good. Oops. Sounds just like what we've been working on. More reverb on the claps, yeah, that sounds good now. Oh, and the Anderson full disclosure, there is a limiter on the master that is mostly for the stream and the video. But it can't influence how something sound. Do we still have that stupid transient doodle on this? Oh no, the reverb's cranked all the way. I knew there was something being weird. All right, we're moving on. Oh, another loop. Man, I put so many friggin' loops. These are the edited ones though. And then we have this. Good God, this is loop mixing. I mean, I guess it's all stems, so it's all basically the same, but there's a lot of drums in this song, my goodness. Oh, this is my favorite loop in the whole thing. The squelch. We can beef up that squelch. It's a squelch and a clap, but. I just want to do the lead so freaking bad. You know what? We're jumping to the lead. We've been doing a lot of loops. Where is it? I want to mix this so bad. Part of me wants to leave it the reward later, but it's such a core of the song, and it's a core of this section. Oh, I'm torn what to work on right now. I want to do the lead. Let's do the lead. I have a plugin called OTT. It's a free plugin from Xfer Records, and here it is. It's interesting looking, and it's basically an upward compressor, but not an expander. I don't totally get it, but it can really reshape the shape of sound. So listen without. With. It is just like it instantly EDMs chiptune. It's very easy to make it sound sus. Super duper sus. But it also can make stuff sound cool. I always EQ after it though because it's really aggressive. Ow, 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 ow. We're gonna notch that. Should be like, whoop! There we go. Spoosh it up. Oh, the pain in my ears is gone. That's coming back, sorry. It's up here. Ah! Okay. Ouch, ouch, ouch. Ouch, 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 ouch. Okay, I get it. Boop, boop, ba-da-doo-doo-doo. I want to do more to this. I want to do more to this lead. I do have this layer. That's not. But it's mostly just to make it sound big. Oh, it does sound big. Boom, ba ba da da ba ba. Boom, ba ba da da ba ba. That part comes next. I have a track that's not even being used. What I would like to do, I guess I should EQ the bottom one, and then I wanna just do like a bunch of fancy like heavy processing stuff to make it freaking huge. But I realize that's the fun stuff. I'm trying to go through the real producer hours stuff to get a song done today. So let's do that. Because you can always go back and like add stuff later. But once every track is treated, once they all have names, they all have EQs, they've all been listened to individually and have reverb, the track is effectively done. And if I want to keep working on it, then that's on me. And it's not like, oh, I can't post that track because there's only reverb on half of it. Or like, I haven't listened to it yet. Like, yeah, you got to do this stuff. But then once it's done, it's like open season. Look how this thing's got no harmonics because I pitched it down. Boop, boop. Oh, wow, I can add some terrible ones. That's nice to know. One thing we can do, like laser shut these off. It might be a really nicer layer clean like that. Listen. Or we can add it back and see if that actually helps. Nope. The high end on this guy is still so intense. I bet it's an OTT. I'm gonna bring it up like this and then bring it down like this. One more EQ, really gentle, right on the top. Oh, nice. Hooray, it is sounding good. Hooray, it is sounding good. All right, I'm gonna group these tracks. I'm gonna name them first. I'm using Ralph's name, Rhythm. I'm not sure that's spelled correctly, but whatever. And then this will be Rhythm minus 12 to indicate that it is an octave lower than the other one. They're the same track, just detuned. And I'm calling this Rhythm. And I like to make my groups all caps because it lets me, when I'm like looking through buses and stuff, the all caps one are clear the group. Ableton has some kind of weird things with groups where, so does the Philadelphia Police Department, apparently. How do I even explain it? Some things don't work very well. If I run into the problem, I'll call it out. But for the most part, groups are pretty easy ways to keep track of multiple tracks. And if you want to process them together, which I do, it's a really great way to do it. I also have an unused Rhythm plus 12 track. I'm just going to put in the group, even though it's not doing anything. And now we get to do something fun. There's a couple of things that might be good. This plugin called Saturn is super awesome distortion plugin, and maybe it can give us some nice quality. There are chip leads, and where's my favorite one? Magic Mastering. Bop. Yo, this is getting pretty EDM, guys. Pretty EDM, guys. Sounded good. And then I have this EQ. I'm going to put the EQ after Saturn. And hopefully it's not totally blasted. I mean, it sounds dope. You can see the notch from earlier, and I have an instinct to add back the frequency that we notched out. Why is that? Maybe we can get it back from the 12 right here. Nope. I know. Let's use a harmonic exciter to, and damn it, I'm using Ozone 5 because I can just use it so much faster and better. We're gonna use a harmonic exciter on the detune, on the low one, to add all the overtones that it's missing. So like here. This is what the waveform looks like right now. We're going to use this plugin, just the low one, please, to add that missing, that stuff on the end that we're missing. And this is how you do it. You just turn up the knob. Lit. Or you can turn up other knobs, too. Oh, it sounded cool now. That one sounds a little butt. That doesn't do anything. And we can see these different options. You can really see how they affect the shape of the sound. That's cool. Whoa. I like tape. Whoa, dual triode though. It adds a buzz, and I really like that buzz. I don't like tape anymore. This doesn't do anything, right? It does. Oh, because of the crossover, but the tiniest bit. So cool, now we have these nice harmonic overtones. Let's see how they play with the other thing. And for my own sake, I'm gonna pull off Saturn and the EQ on the group, so I don't listen to that. Let's hear the whole thing. All right, let's throw Saturn on. It sounds sweet. I like it a lot. It sounds so cool. Let's throw some reverb on it and then let's unleash it into the mix. I'm getting excited about this track now. Side chains will help. I was EQing there because once, when the track sounded all good and awesome by itself, I put it in with the whole mix and everything else, and then I was able to notice some things that I thought were affecting it in not such a cool way. Mostly that it had way too much low mids. It sounded awesome on its own, super big and powerful, but then when I put it in with everything else, I unsoloed the tracks, I could hear that there's way too much low mids in the song. So I just went ahead and shelved off some, and apparently it took all my brain power because I couldn't explain it while I was doing it. I had to finish. Did I get to the kick yet? Oh, that's why there's no side chaining on this track, because the kicks are everywhere. There are kicks in so many different loops. There's one here, loop 84. There's one in here. Oh, those are claps. I was wrong. Okay, actually, it's not so bad. Oh, and then there's the bass. I'm gonna use the bass for this. And I also remember that loop 84 is got a kick in it. So back to our lead. Where is it? Side change to the bass. I want it punchier. I'm gonna side change to the kick in loop 84 as well. Loop 84, EQ, low cut, that should select the kick. Yep, see it? Or hear it? Bo, bo, bo. I'll show you guys a really cool trick. Because I like how this is ducking with the kick, but not with the bass. I feel like it's taking too much of the do-da-do-da-do-da away. But what we can do is I can create, this is a technical thing, I'm going to do my best to explain it while I'm doing it. Inserting a new return track, and I'm calling it the bass key. It's the bass key, it unlocks the bass. Actually, it doesn't, it is the bass. I'm going to send the bass to that all the way. Now I have a copy of the bass going to this D track that's his bass key. Now, that's gonna just sound like two basses, and that's not what we want. What I want to do to that is send that bass again to a multiband compressor. Now, that sure sounds like a bunch of mumbo jumbo, just at least coming out of my mouth. So hopefully you can hear the effect that it has. I'm gonna say, yo, this bass. Then I'm gonna say, that bass key track, let's send this track to our rhythm group, where our do-da-do-da-do-das are, and send it to the side chain of the multiband. Good God, I've never said this stuff out loud. It's so intense, the words, whoo! So then it works, right? I'll click, expert, because I'm an expert. Say exterior source for the side chain, and now the bass that Ralph played, this, triggers the side chain on our duty duty duties, our rhythm track. And what it lets us do is pull the bass out of our rhythm when our actual bass hits. You hear how the bass like disappears? The drum reverb is so intense. That reverb might not be done. See? Can you hear? Doing this crazy complicated thing should allow us to keep the bass in our duty, duty, duties, keep the bass as the baseline, that yellow track at the top, and have everybody be friends. Let's check it out. All together, please. All right. I think we're done with that. I think we're done with that rhythm track, finally. Good God, there's so many tracks in this mix. And it's not that there are just so many little things. There's so many giant, significant. Oh, these all sound mixed already. All right, cool, we're getting there. The rhythm group's done. What else do we have? We have that plus 12 track not being used. We have this, oh, the whooshies. The whooshies are mixed, right? Gosh, I've been doing this for almost 50 minutes now. I really thought I was gonna just tear ass through all these tracks, but then I've ended up spending all this time on these little important pieces. And this sweep, the final sweep as I call it, isn't usually a 1 hour thing, but depending on how much time I've put into the track, I guess that dictates how much more there is left to do. But I guess the thesis is I went into this track just simply knowing that it wasn't done and being a little like, oh my gosh, this track's not done. I guess I'm gonna hop up on camera and try to finish it with some semblance of accountability. And by doing this sweeping method of just basically going from top to bottom, jumping around a little if I want, but changing the name of a track and doing a specific thing, which is EQ on everything, and then just doing everything else I hear, I'm making real progress on this track that I felt blocked on. I felt like I was blocked, but I've created this reverb that I really like. I've mixed, you know, a third of the song, and I've set the foundation for it to be finished. And I know what I need to do. Just keep sweeping until all those tracks have names, like this one. We will call sweeps. It is a sweeps. And yeah, basically this is my workflow for finishing songs. Cause it's easy to start stuff cause it's the fun and exciting when it's fresh and you just go in. But if you don't finish in that first sitting or it's a bigger project like this one, it's nice to have a workflow that can rely on to get things done. This needs delay. Oh, I already have delays set up. That's great. I'm gonna try putting Saturn on it, even though I really like how it sounds already. Where's my magic mastering? I don't think we need this kind of intensity. I mean, it sure makes those low moments sound really nice. And then we don't need this, but we do need this. I always make sure if I'm doing any kind of processing that there's an EQ after the processing thing, because like every plugin makes stupid bass, adds stupid bass frequencies that just get in the way. Gosh, that was salty. Sorry about that. Let's sidechain this thing. I should be sidechaining just about freaking everything. Now that I figured out exactly what, there's gonna be a lot of sidechains in this track, isn't it? This should be like another sweep, another pass after this mixing thing. It would be the sidechains. Yeah, that's what it's gonna be. Okay, so I didn't talk about this early in the video because I don't plan my videos enough, sorry. I have Evernote open and I'm going through and sweeps. Actually, I call these passes. But we're sweeping for EQ. I'm not even gonna call it sweeping anymore because that's an easy thing to say out loud, but what do I call it? What do we need to do on every track? We need to EQ every track. We need to side chain. We need to do check for side chains. Check for EQ. Check. Gosh, guys, for EQ. Check for side chains. We have built our reverb. We have built our, send to reverb. Delay is not mandatory, processing is not mandatory, name track. Here it is, the stuff that we need to do to finish the track. I have to go through every track and do these things. Check for the EQ, check for sidechains, send to reverb, name the track. Once I've done these four things on everything, the track is effectively done. So I really should have started this stream with this list, but I got in, I had some fun, and I'm feeling good about this track. So I'm gonna mix a little bit more for a few more minutes, make a little debrief, and yeah, we'll stop the stream, we'll move on to something else. If you're watching on YouTube, thanks. Let's start the track from the beginning, and I'm feeling pretty good about this. Hey, that one was already done. Here's the big part. Well, nope, that's not right. Holy shit, there's a lot going on here. Whoa, there's a lot going on. This is the only synth in the song. This noble serum. We got a new group here. Group the tracks. This is the lead. This is Serum Lair. I'm gonna check my other group. What did I do? Saturn, sidechain, EQ, EQ. Oh, EQ, sidechain. Let's take that chain, move it over to the leads too. That Saturn's probably gonna really glue it together. I forgot a limitation is that I can't send these synths to multiple places. If I need to do this sidechain thing, I can only do it on one track at a time. Maybe I don't need it. Boop. Let's hear. Yeah, no, it's good that lead is punching through like that. Rather than sending each individual track to the reverb, I'm gonna send the whole lead bus as a to the reverb, hopefully to make it sound more cohesive, like one big. This lead has so much going on, my goodness. These mid EQs, just like, let's just get more aggressive. We're gonna just notch, bow, make a big hole. Thank you. Whoa. All it does is add distortion. You can't even hear it. So I'll pull that off and look, all of a sudden, our lead is effectively the same, still cool and like fucking, kind of like gets screechy and like metal, but you just have that low end out of here. Let's pull the drive down a little. Nope, that was wrong. That's the shriek I wanted, but it doesn't go so high. But then there's this little peepy peep. What's that? That has to be its own track. That is not, that sound going through that chain is like super huge. Well, maybe it's not in the whole scheme of things. Let's listen. No, it's not. No, it's not. I don't hate it. It's cool. Let's listen to the drop. I think we got it. Yeah. This track is finally coming together. I don't even know what to call this. This is like the Bediddles. I'm gonna call it the Climbers. We're coming together. I was gonna cap this stream at an hour, but I'm going for it. I think maybe we can finish this whole tune in this sitting. I mean, gosh, it's like the fourth or fifth day I've worked on this tune, so it should be, we should be able to just wrap the mix and start on mastering. At least start on having fun with it again. This is a freaking cool sound, Ralph. But what we do need is the Pro MB. We do. For this one. Where's that resonance? Is it here? I'm not really good at multi-band on individual tracks, you know? We've been putting Saturn on a lot of stuff. I wonder if that's the right instrument for this, the right effect for this. That's where the pain comes from. That's actually where the pain comes from. Interesting. No, but I want a glue. I want something to make this like more solid. We're gonna use Unplugged. Another Waves plugin by Chris Lord Age, I think is how you say his name. All of his stupid named presets though. The hell does any of this mean, man? Mix compactor. Sounds like something I use every day. Stringman. Sunset Strip sounds nice. Oh, I was wrong. I was wrong. Yo, screw this shit. We're in it. Take some of the bite out. Spank it. Delay. You can, now it has two reverbs that you can delay separately, which is very cool. We're gonna delay the reverb. Yeah, it's pretty cool. Canyon. No, Room is nice. But Canyon is also ridiculous. Ooh, that gives it a real bump. The low end. Bop, 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 bop. Cool. Oh, Saturn's still on after it. Interesting. Not what I intended to do, but... Oh, listen to that, though! That's cool. It's that pop. It's the pop from the programming. Whenever, I think Ralph made this on one of the DS music making programs, and it must be a tracker because when the note hits the note on message, there's like a pop. It happens in chiptune a lot. And we're like using this guy and then Saturn, and I guess even OTT at the beginning of the chain, we're really accentuating that pop and making like this percussion element out of this like airy synth that was sort of hidden. The question is, can we EQ it so we can still hear that pop, but it doesn't break the song? And we're gonna find that out right now. Oops. Yeah. There it is. So we'll still have room for our bass. Let's hear it. This got very cool. This is not what I expected for the sound, but it's cool. Let's see if it's cooperative. Holy shit, it sounds awesome. This area still has got some, it's got some things that are not totally being friends. Like whatever this renegade is. Oh yeah, these are just like the shrieks. I have two tracks that just have awful names. What? Climbers and Shrieks. I'm gonna keep the shrieks muted for now because I think they're causing problems. Those are the shrieks. That. This is cool. This is cool. I'm liking it. Let's hear without the drums. Back to the start. Let's hear this new piece. We're making it. We're making our way through this thing. There's not a whole lot left to do. I'm gonna try something tricky, something old school. I am pulling out the Waves C1 compressor. This is the compressor that paved the way for like basically all modern compressors. And it has a feature that most modern compressors don't, which is a negative ratio or a less than one. And we can use that as an expander, I believe, which will make our make this sound a little more dynamic or super intense. There we go. I want like a punchy poppiness. Need the fast attack for this to work. Ha ha. Yo, this track's getting crazy. Let's duck this to the bass. Loop 42 controls this section, so we'll go loop 42. Turn that side chaining on. Just the bass, please. This is nice. I like this a lot. There we go. Oh, let's EQ it. That'll help, I hope. Yeah, that's what we want. There we go. There's a lot of processing on this already, but clearly I did this for some reason. Well, I had taken care of this stuff, and then I... This is a weird track. You know, I've seen a trick to sort of soften tracks like this, and it is to just put reverb on it directly. I don't do this very often, but let's give it a go. Oh, it's interesting. It really does soften it. I liked it. The economy setting is nicer. No, it's not. Sorry, I had to listen to it twice. The mid is definitely the grossest, though. Mid quality. Hey, this is really cool. This is really shaping the sound a lot. This is Ableton's built-in reverb. Neat! That really fixed, that really patched up that track. Who would have thought it? Stock reverb coming through. This is awesome. We're really tearing through. There's so many loops. God. How many are left, though? We did squelch. We have 7 and 8. There are more leads. What's going on? This track is enormous. My goodness. It's only 25 tracks, but it's so big. There's so many extremely different things. I guess there's not a lot of stuff's layered. Maybe the stuff's mixed? Yeah, it is. That one. That one's not. That one's not either. Woof. I'm gonna have to call it on this video, guys. I'll let the track play right now so you can hear what it sounds like. But clearly there's more to do here. So if you like this kind of video, let me know, okay? Let me know. This is Magikarp Festival featuring Ralphington. I'm DJ Cutman. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned something. If you have any questions, hit me up. I'll do my best to answer. This is what it looks like right now. Get out of here, you. Ooh, yeah. This is my remix of Magikarp Festival featuring Ralphington. It's coming soon to the Game Chops YouTube channel, so get up on there. All right, I'm Cutman. I've got to take a break from the stream right now. If you're watching on Cutman Plays, leave a subscribe. It really does help. If you have any questions about productions or whatever, just hit me up, Video Game DJ on Twitter, or of course in the comments section. I do my best to keep up. Thanks for watching. Thank you, Ralphington, for giving me these stems for this mix. And I'll see y'all again real soon. I'm Cutman. See you later. Oh no, that was the ending.